Welcome back. Now, in an endeavour to recognise the contribution of teachers to the society, Rotary Club of Madras felicitated a total of 43 teachers from 9 different schools across Chennai. 43 teachers marking the 43 years of existence of the Rotary Club. The teachers were chosen on the back of their deliberations and their involvement from beyond the classrooms to ensure holistic development of students. And the schools include Chettinad Vidyashram, Maharishi Vidya Mandir, Government High Secondary School Kelambakam, Government School Ramapuram and PSP Millennium Porur, to name a few. Now, other than felicitation, this event was also provided an opportunity for exchange of thoughts between teachers. The club also conducted half-day workshops for these teachers to add value to their expertise. Well, marking the World Suicide Prevention Day, Sneha, a non-religious, a non-political organization, organized an awareness campaign. Now, various speakers spoke of awareness as the key to tackling suicides. Now, the focus was clearly on improving education and decreasing stigmatization. The theme for 2011, in fact, is preventing suicides in multicultural societies. Now, Magsaysay awardee and renowned journalist on farm suicides, P. Sainath, was the keynote speaker. He stressed on how, though Tamil Nadu doesn't see high levels of farm suicides, the number of suicides in general in the state looked worrisome. Now, meanwhile, Sneha, the NGO too, celebrated 25 years of service. The NGO can be reached on 2464-0050.
5 to 2009 is 241,000 farmers. Now, the worst states are Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. These five states account for two-thirds of the farm suicides. Tamil Nadu is not amongst the worst state of farmers' suicides, though it has a high number of general suicides. But Tamil Nadu's farmers' suicides in 2009, though it is lower than these states, it doubled. From 500 odd, it crossed 1200. That is a doubling in 1 year, which is a serious matter.
Well, in some national updates now, the entire opposition has opposed the draft of communal violence bill at the National Integration Council meeting in the capital. Now, the Sonia Gandhi-led National Advisory Council, which drafted the bill, met with strong opposition. Arun Jaitley and Sushma Swaraj took on the NAC, calling the draft dangerous. Now, Arun Jaitley said that the NAC draft is non-secular and denies equivalence even in terms of communal law. Now, the meeting was chaired by the Prime Minister.
बिल बहुत ही खतरनाक बिल है क्योंकि एक तो ये बिल देश के संघीय ढांचे पर प्रहार करता है लॉ एंड ऑर्डर और पब्लिक ऑर्डर दोनों स्टेट सब्जेक्ट हैं लेकिन ये बिल सारे के सारे अधिकार अपने हाथ में ले रहा है राज्य सरकारों को बाहर करके तो ये केंद्र राज्य सरकारों के संबंध में बहुत ही खतरनाक बिल है और दूसरा ये बिल किसी भी व्यक्ति को नागरिक नहीं मानता किसी को इंसान नहीं मानता हर देशवासी को अल्पसंख्यक और बहुसंख्यक में बांट रहा है और साथ ही ये घोषणा कर रहा है कि हर बहुसंख्यक अन्यायी है और हर अल्पसंख्यक पीड़ित है यानी बहुसंख्यक के व्यक्ति ने क्या चरित्र है उसका क्या किया है उसने क्या उसकी कार्यशैली है ये ना देखकर केवल जन्म उसका बहुसंख्यक में हुआ है इस कारण से वो अन्यायी हो जाता है और अल्पसंख्यक कोई अपराध करता है या नहीं क्योंकि अल्पसंख्यक में पैदा हुआ है इसलिए वो पीड़ित हो जाता है हमने ये कहा कि ये देश इतना बड़ा है कि इसमें हर जगह
एज इट स्टैंड्स व्हाट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड आई हैव नॉट गॉन थ्रू द बिल बट व्हाटएवर आई नो द तृणमूल कांग्रेस वुड अपोज दिस बिल
द एनएसी ड्राफ्ट
एनएसी
Well, in staying with some national updates now, the Delhi blast is widely being seen as an intelligence failure. And the Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, addressing the meeting of the National Integration Council, emphasized that there is a need to upgrade and strengthen investigative agencies and intelligence gathering. He also said that the terrorists' misplaced sense of ideology cannot justify the violence.
The terrorist attack in Delhi last Wednesday is a stark reminder to us that there can be no let-up in our vigilance. Time and again, our nation has been subjected to terrorist violence. Terrorists seek to justify such violence based on misplaced sense of ideology. The institutions and instruments of our democratic polity allow sufficient opportunity for articulating different points of view without recourse to violence. No civilized society can tolerate or endorse loss of innocent lives in the pursuit of any ideology. This council must unequivocally send out a message that pursuit of violence cannot be justified under any circumstance and reaffirm our collective resolve.
And in developments just coming in, BJP has asked Uttarakhand Chief Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, who faced corruption charges, to step down. BJP Parliamentary Board met today to discuss the leadership change in Uttarakhand. Now, Major General B.C. Khanduri is likely to be sworn in tomorrow as the next Chief Minister. Well, excuse me. Now, more skeletons in the illegal mining case. The YSR government allotted thousands of acres of government land at throwaway prices to Gali Jonathan Reddy for a captive steel plant. Now, this steel plant never came up, but Reddy was allowed to export all the iron ore that was supposed to be mined for that very steel plant. Now, the state government now says YSR took the decision himself without taking his cabinet's approval.
A grand opening for Gali Jonathan Reddy's Brahmani Steels in June 2007. Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Rajshekhar Reddy arrived at Jamalamadugu in Kadapa in a chopper. Also present were his son Jagan Mohan Reddy and several of his cabinet colleagues. Some 10,760 acres of government land was given for the setting up of a 20,000 crore rupees captive steel plant, another 4,000 acres for an airport, and there was promise of 10,000 direct jobs and another 1 lakh indirect jobs.
చాలా పెద్ద ఎయిర్పోర్ట్ అంటే ఇవాళ హైదరాబాదు బెంగళూరు మెడ్రాస్ లాంటి చెన్నై లాంటి ప్రదేశాల్లో ఉన్నటువంటి పెద్ద విమానాలు ఏమైతే ఉన్నాయో నేరుగా ఇక్కడ వచ్చి దిగడానికి.
ఈవెన్ బై 2011 నో స్టీల్ ప్లాంట్ హస్ కమ్ అప్. గాలి జనార్దన్ రెడ్డి యూజ్ ద ల్యాండ్ దట్ హీ గాట్ ఫర్ 18 క్రోర్ రూపీస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ టు రేస్ 350 క్రోర్ రూపీస్. He also reportedly exported over 54 lakh tons of iron ore that was meant to be used by the steel plant. The state government has now distanced itself from what it says was YSR's decision.
Allotment of iron ore, that is captive mining, to Obulapuram company, another Anantapur mining company, and another Mahabaleshwarappa company, like that. There are four or five companies. That is a decision taken by the then Chief Minister, Mr. Rajshekhar Reddy, not by the cabinet. But as far as the Brahmani industries is concerned, for all the concessions that were made, the cabinet is collectively responsible.
While finalizing that contract, they have eliminated competitors in the name of Brahmani Steels captive unit. Again, they have given a GO to sell iron ore anywhere as they like. This is how they manipulated like anything in this process.
With local pressure building up, the government is keen to get the alienated land back from Brahmani Steels. But experts say that involves legal complications. There are allegations galore from both within the Congress and the opposition about Jagan Mohan Reddy getting a stake in companies like Brahmani Steel in return for his father favouring a particular promoter. But a chief minister is not deemed to be acting alone. Presumably, grant of land and licenses and also approval of projects is a collective cabinet decision. So will YSR's cabinet colleagues be made answerable is the moot question. In Hyderabad, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.
And while up ahead, Salman Khan wants to play a real-life bodyguard and find out who the lucky one is on the other side.